Family resource specialist with Early Steps. I am a parent of a child that was in the program, and that's one of the requirements of our position. Also, I help to connect the families with different resources and help them navigate the Early Steps system. I also meet them when they come to the clinic for their evaluations. We do different resource fairs. We're out in the community letting the families know that this is a free program available to them, free of charge, and that there is no qualifications. You just need to come in and have your child evaluated if you have a concern for a developmental delay. Some children are in daycares, and when they do it, the daycares do a screening. The screening may show up that they may be a tentative delay. So they ask the families to come in and have the evaluation with Early Steps. And that's how some families come in. Other families are directed to us through their pediatrician, and also families are directed to us through the NICU at the hospitals in Broward County. You shouldn't ignore any signs that there may be a delay or something different about your child. When the school notifies you, it's time to act and come in, give us a call, call Child Find, and then they will do the referral to Early Steps. Also, there are times when the pediatrician will suggest that you take the child in and have the evaluation done, and they will do a referral. If your child is born prematurely, when at the NICU, at the hospitals, we will come to you and give you an invitation to Early Steps to have the child evaluated. So we try to cover all the bases because early detection is so important. The Early Steps program is here for you. And once we detect that if there is a delay, then we're here to provide the services to your family free of charge. So that's an incentive for you to come out because with my experience was that when they came to me in the NICU and told me that my child may have a delay, she was a little premature, I was like, okay, so you know what to do next. And when I came, they gave her an evaluation in five areas, and then they provided services for her. Now, she was in Early Steps until she turned three, and then she went on to preschool and then to regular school. She's presently in college. And the good thing is that had I not come in when I did, she might have lost her sight because one of her issues was vision, and she was losing her sight in one eye. But you don't see that because the child looks at you and they smile with you. You know, you think everything is fine, but the evaluation allowed me to find out that these things were going, underlying factors were going on. So, and when you come in, it's so important for you to be part of the process. Early intervention, we work with the families. We want our families to know that you're part of the process. So when they say, we're gonna provide this service, that service, it's not just take the child to the doctor or the therapist and sit in the waiting room. You need to get involved and say, well, what are you doing with the child? What's happening? You know, what therapies are you doing? So when you're home with that baby, you can also continue working with the child. That has been my experience with raising my daughter, with learning the therapies and the motions that they were providing for her, and also making sure she made her appointments to the specialist, to the eye doctor, and getting the glasses that she needed, and seeking out the resources. I had a service coordinator in Early Steps that helped me to find the resources in the community that would pay for the special glasses that she needed. So we're here for you. We don't just say, oh, your child is sick, you know, do this. We work with the family. My experience with my foster children was that when these young ones were coming into my home, I was like, wow, there's something not right. You know, I wonder if the parent looked into it. But I was able to make a self-referral to Early Steps and have them evaluated. And I found out quite a few of them. I've fostered 13 children, and I would say 7 of them were in the Early Steps program and have gone on. Currently, I have 3 in the Early Steps program. Well, 2. One just graduated, and he had cerebral palsy. One, there's a little, she's very tiny, so there may be some genetics going on. And the other one came to me on an apnea monitor, so he had breathing problems. and he came from the NICU. Some of the signs that parents can look for in their children to see if there's a need or if there's anything going on is that if you have a one-year-old that's not speaking or not saying at least 50 words or more, that is a flag. That is a sign that maybe something is going on. If you have a child that has to do certain routines before they can go to the next step, that may be a sign. If you have a six-month-old that's not rolling over or trying to push up or babbling, you know, every baby, cuckoo, blah, blah, blah. If they're not doing those things, then you should be concerned. And just have it, you know, it may be nothing, but you never know. And our program is free.